Workman Publishing and Workman Audio present 27 Essential Principles of Story. Master the Secrets of Great Storytelling, from Shakespeare to South Park, by Daniel Joshua Rubin. Read by Daniel Joshua Rubin. For Karen and Sally, my two favorite stories, and Tim Urjavac, we had some laughs. See you on the other side. Introduction. Old school, new adrenaline. This book was inspired by the way martial arts are taught. The best schools focus relentlessly on drilling fundamentals. Here, the fundamentals are old school principles of plot, character, setting, dialogue, and theme. The same ones Aristotle wrote about more than 2,100 years ago, but updated and given a shot of adrenaline. No matter what form your story takes, whether you're writing a novel, screenplay, TV series, podcast, web series, graphic novel, comic book, song, or just telling a story, these universal principles apply. This is classic dramatic structure made simple. By classic dramatic structure, I mean stories with a beginning, middle, and end that build tension, keep your audience guessing what will happen, are fueled by intense emotion, and resolve in a meaningful way. If you want a path to follow to help you tell a coherent, authentic story, you will find what you need here. If you are more of a free spirit, you can study each principle in isolation and use only the ones that feel essential to you. The key word here is you. Storytelling is a personal and revealing art. You write stories to express the truth as you see it. My hope is that each chapter will help you figure out how to execute each principle in your own unique way. You won't find any literary theory, academic puffery, or slick jargon. All 27 principles are stated simply, in plain English. This is important for two reasons. One is that it makes it simpler to understand and master each principle. Terms you may have heard or learned in class, such as inciting incident and climax, can be problematic because, in the context of story, they don't mean what they usually mean. A climax is a high point of tension. But in story, the climax refers to when the central dramatic question is answered, which is often not the high point of tension. It's simply the moment we learn how things turn out. But more important, cutting out the convoluted terminology creates space for you to fill with your own unique intellect, personality, and heart. For example, chapter 12 is called simply Provoke Dilemma. When you force your characters to struggle through impossible choices, you reveal who they are. Because this concept is so simply stated, your mind immediately goes to work thinking up dilemmas for your characters to face. And no two writers construct the same types of dilemmas, so you get the benefit of executing a timeless and fundamental principle, but in your own way. You get to have your cake and eat it too. The 27 principles will give you enough direction to avoid getting lost, but not so much that it strangles your creativity. And you can use this book any way you want. You don't have to read it cover to cover or start with chapter one. Some writers find inspiration in a line of dialogue or an idea or personality. That's fine. You can start by reading one of the chapters on dialogue or one on theme or character. The emphasis here is on practical value. This book exists to serve your needs. If you're already in the middle of a story but feel stuck, the dialogue's not sharp, the characters don't feel distinct, you're not sure what it all adds up to, you will find an answer to your problem. If you invest a small amount of time, a few weeks tops, actually doing the work of carefully working through these chapters, you'll be astounded by how much insight you gain. You don't need to invest north of $200,000 in a fancy degree. You need fundamental principles and the confidence that comes from knowing you've truly mastered them. Each chapter is structured the same way. Up first is a quick take that explains the basic idea. Then we'll break down the mechanics of how it works, just like car nuts break down auto parts to see how they work. Next, in How a Master Did It, we'll detail how one of the greatest storytellers throughout time, in all media, executed the principle. This is not theory. I will show you how they did it. Then, in how you do it, it's always about you. We'll bullet point, step by step, how you execute the principle in your own work. This will teach you how professional writers think through story. Then you'll take a mini final exam. These are fun little stories that relate to the principle at hand and are followed by a single multiple choice question. The goal for these is to reinforce the principle and to give you that extra shot of confidence that comes from knowing you have command of it. And it doesn't end there. In continuing ed, you'll be told about another story that beautifully executes the principle, along with some questions to think about so you can further explore the principle on your own. When you finish a chapter, it will feel as if you've installed the principle in your brain, just like putting software onto a hard drive. Again, this methodology is inspired by martial arts. You will never hear a black belt complain about working on fundamentals. They spend countless hours on the basics: breathing, striking, kicking, blocking, stances, mentality, and movement. But here's the key thing about martial arts. No two people will execute the moves in the same way. Inevitably, we bring our own personality and style to everything we do. This is not about assembling bookcases from IKEA that all look exactly alike. We're talking about telling your story. The goal is to help you engage in more constructive, insightful conversation with yourself to discover what you truly think and feel. One of the pleasures of writing this book was diving deep into the stories and how a master did it. They are all extraordinary, and no two are alike. To my knowledge, this is the most diverse collection of stories ever assembled in a book on writing. It's not the Western canon. You'll find a wide variety of media and genres, and storytellers from different time periods in all walks of life. You'll explore a new generation of masters, including Juno Diaz, Jhumpa Lahiri, Alison Bechdel, Samantha Schweblin, and Eminem. This diverse lineup is not about being politically correct. Fuck that. I'm the least politically correct guy on earth. It's about developing a more complete picture of what it means to be human. Now, you might be wondering who the hell I am and what gives me the right to lecture the world on story. It's a fair and important question. I'm not Stephen King, and I don't fancy myself to be some know-it-all guru, but I've paid my dues and then some. I've written on staff for shows on the WB and NBC. I've been playwright in residence at the Steppenwolf Theater in Chicago, produced video series for the global financial media company The Motley Fool, and I once did a three-figure development deal with the National Lampoon. Ha ha. No, really. And we came an inch away from selling that TV pitch about my real-life experience as a rodeo beer vendor to Comedy Central. I've been represented by some of the biggest agencies in Hollywood. I've studied and worked with the most successful writers, directors, and actors of all time. I've taught dramatic writing at Loyola University Chicago and the University of California San Diego. I founded my own writing studio, Story 27, in Evanston, Illinois. And I hold a Bachelor of Science in Drama Studies from the State University of New York at Purchase and an MFA in Playwriting from Yale. The bottom line is, I've lived the writing life for more than 25 years. I've done some really cool things and made some big mistakes. I've learned what's essential and what is not. Though story is art, and art is, of course, subjective, I have tried as hard as I could to focus on the principles that are as close to objective truth as possible. If you clash expectation with reality, see Chapter 6 on Breaking Bad, mask characters' true selves, see Chapter 16 on Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, and earn transformations, see Chapter 17 on Fun Home, you will write better, smarter, and more authentic stories. Lastly, before you start, a word of warning. These principles are more interrelated than a Kentucky picnic, and all ultimately share the same goals: to help you write something essential. You will see the following words repeated throughout: necessary, authentic, inspired, intense, intelligent, emotional, revealing, passionate, essential, critical. I think you get the point. This is not the book for people who want to score a quick buck by writing about a cop who partners with a schnauzer. It's for writers who have something important to say, who take stories seriously, who dream of writing something meaningful, who feel that if they don't tell the story that's been stuck in their gut like a bullet, they can never be content, who want to write to the very best of their ability and, if the gods are with them, rattle the world. If this feels like you, welcome to the tribe. Find me on Twitter at Dan Joshua Rubin and let me know how it goes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.